Welcome back. Day two of the Republican National Convention kicks off in a matter of hours.
CNN's Ivan Rodriguez is live in Milwaukee for us this morning with what happened on day one and what will be discussed today. Good morning.
Tracy, Clay, good morning. We are expecting a focus more on safety as that main theme today. But going off of what we saw yesterday, obviously a big news was the selection of Senator J.D. Vance as Trump's running mate. And when you do look at most assessments of the electoral map, it begins to make a little bit of sense why Trump picked Senator J.D. Vance. Looking at it, it seems Joe Biden must win at least Pennsylvania, Michigan, and Wisconsin, and then add a single electoral vote in Omaha, Nebraska, in order to get to those 270 electoral votes to then clinch the presidency. And Vance could help Trump close off that path for President Biden.
After months of speculation,
it is therefore my honor to nominate Ohio Senator J.D. Vance for the office of Vice President of the United States of America.
Senator J.D. Vance now joins former President Trump as his running mate in the final stretch to the general election.
I have the vision and the agenda aligned with President Trump to make the American worker better off, to bring peace to the world, and to actually advance an agenda that's good for American citizens.
Party leaders also showered Trump with immense support on the first day of the convention, with House Speaker Mike Johnson introducing the roll call to nominate the 45th president for a second term.
The chair announces that President Donald J. Trump, having received a majority of the votes entitled to be cast at the convention, has been selected as the Republican Party nominee for President of the United States.
Monday's theme, Make America Wealthy Once Again.
The income of everyday Americans are shrinking in the face of inflation, at the gas pumps, at the grocery store, with the electrical bill, and with the car insurance. This has got to change.
Tuesday's theme, Make America Safe Once Again, where Trump's proposals to bolster law enforcement and combat illicit drugs will be front and center.
Trump called Vance to offer him the position about 20 minutes before he then made the announcement on True Social. It also is worth noting that Vance remains largely unknown nationwide. In the most recent CNN poll, 66% of registered voters say they had either never heard of Vance or didn't know enough about him to make a solidified opinion. Former President Trump also making his first appearance at the convention last night with a bandage over his right ear. Tracy, Clay.
Hey, Ivan, let's pick it up from there. You mentioned the president being there, the former president being there with the bandage. What else are you hearing about the investigation into that assassination attempt?
Well, the rally security failure really has put the Secret Service at odds with its local law enforcement allies. In an interview with ABC News, the director of the Secret Service, Kimberly Cheadle, said that local police were actually inside of the building that the shooter used to then climb up on top of that roof, and that it was local law enforcement's responsibility to secure that building. She went on to say that a local sniper team was actually on the second floor of that building, and they were providing overwatch for the crowd at that rally. On the other front of the investigation, investigators are still struck by the lack of leads that they're finding in terms of the shooter's mindset and possible motive for this attack. They've conducted hundreds of interviews, family and friends as well. And so for the most part, they're still working to really find that motive. Even after gaining access to his phone, going through his social media accounts, browse history, they still haven't been able to identify it yet.
So a lot of questions still looking for answers.
Sure.
Von Rodriguez live in Milwaukee, Wisconsin for us at the RNC. Thank you for your time this morning.